Hello my students, welcome back in our class. Today we will start chapter number 11 and that is the chapter Australia. So first we will study that where our Australia is actually located. This is our Earth and this is the equator. This is our equator. So this equator is divided our Earth into the two segments. First one is northern hemisphere and second one is southern hemisphere. Why I am telling this, that northern hemisphere, southern hemisphere, that I will come to there. First you study that one. So here this is the northern and southern hemisphere and this Australia, or you can say the Oceania. That is, Oceania is actually the continent and Australia is the country. So, and the Australia is completely most largest country in the Oceania, one of the largest country. Largest country in Oceania. So this Australia is located in the southern hemisphere. Southern hemisphere, fully it is locating in the southern hemisphere. Nothing, the half part is locating in the northern hemisphere. Nothing is there. Full part is locating in the southern hemisphere. If I will see, I will draw that here it is the locating our Australia. That if it is here locating, then how we have to write the location, means the longitudinal location and the latitudinal location. Longitudinal and latitudinal location means this is the Earth. Here are some latitudes. These are our latitudes. And these are our longitudes. So, whenever we need to know actual location of a place, then we have to find out and then we have to know the longitude and the latitude of this location, means longitudinal location and the latitudinal location. Here also I will, we have to know the longitudinal and the latitudinal location. This is our place and these are the longitudes. This is the middle one, is the prime meridian. This is the location. Now you can understand properly. This is the location. And what is the longitudinal or the latitudinal location? So this, if I will rub it, all these things, then we will get only this line and this line, and this is the border line. This is one longitude, sorry, latitude, and this is another latitude. From this latitude to this latitude, here it is locating, and from this longitude to this longitude, here it is locating. So it is come to like that, this place. This place. This is the Australia. So from where to where it is located? So this one is the 10 degree 41 minute south. This one, that one. That is the 10 degree 41 minute south. First of all, I want to say that why I am writing here south? Because of the Australia, it is locating in the southern hemisphere. For that, this is, we are writing the south. Here it is the S, so we have to write also the S because it is the southern hemisphere. This is the 10 degree 41 minute south. And now next is the 43 degree 38 minute south. 43 degree 38 minute south. You have to read this location, the latitudinal and the longitudinal location, that is in your book, you have to read this. So, this, here is also the south. So, from this line, is a 10 degree, that is a 10 degree line. So this location is 10 degree 41 minutes south, and this location is 43 degree 38 minutes south. Now I will come to the longitudinal location. Longitudinal location, here it is 139 degree 9 minutes. Yes. East. Why I have writing here east? Because this is actually locating in the eastern hemisphere. So here I will draw another arc. This is the prime meridian, and this prime meridian also dividing our arc into two segments. So one is the eastern hemisphere, another one is the western hemisphere. So eastern and the western hemisphere, fully the Australia is locating in the eastern hemisphere. So whenever we have to write the longitudinal location, then we have to write the east. That means 113 degree 9 minute east, and the 153 degree, that is that one, 153 degree 38 minute east. It can be little bit change in your book what will be, that I didn't see, but 38 37, like that it will be 130 degree 9 minute to 153 degree 38 minute east. So south in the for the latitudinal location, and north east for the longitudinal location. This is the location of the Australia. So the official name of the Australia is the Commonwealth of Australia. Commonwealth of Australia. That is the official name of the Australia. But generally we are using the only Australia. So from where the name has come, that is the word Terra Australis. From that word, this Australia has come. The meaning of this word is southern. So already you know, in the southern hemisphere, fully in the southern hemisphere it is locating, and in the earth, totally in the downside it is locating. So it is nearer to the almost the south pole. It's not actually the south pole, so nearer to the towards the south. So that is why it is, the name is come from the southern. That is the name. The name derived the Australia. From where the name derived? From the Australia. And the Australia is the only one and only nation which is occupies the total whole Oceania. One nation that is fully occupied the Oceania. That is the one and only nation. And already I said before that it is the largest country in the Australia, in the Oceania. And also it is the largest country, sixth largest country among the world. Why it is sixth largest country among the world? According to the total area, it is the sixth largest country among the world. These are the some normal features of the Australia. Now the next is the who found the Australia. That is the James Cook. It's a sailor, not actually the sailor, it's a Navy captain who explored the Australia. Firstly, he find out the place which is the name as the Newfoundland. That place, after that it was the, because of the British, he was British, that is why the place was the British colony. After that, it belongs to the some Australian tribes. Now, I will go to the boundaries. Let's start the boundaries. Before going to the boundary, I want to say that here is a main one parallel. That is the one of the between among all the five main parallels of our earth. This is one parallel that is Tropic of Capricorn. That line has go through this between this Australia. So in our earth, these are five main parallels, and this is the Tropic of Cancer. Cancer, and this is the Tropic of Capricorn. So this line is has go through the between the Australia. Here it is. So now I will go to the boundary. Actually, this Australia is made up with the main, this Oceania is made up with the main Australian continent. Next is the Tasmania Islands. And more small islands. These are actually total made of with the islands. So here this is the Australia, and surrounding this Australia no land is here. Surrounding this Australia all are the water. All full of water, these are surrounding this Australia. Full of these are water. No land is here. Which are land? These are the neighboring countries. But between the Australia and these lands, these are the countries, neighboring countries. Between that also there is a water, water bodies. So that is why this Australia is called the island. This is the island country. Actually, it is the island country. Why it is called island country? You can easily understand, because it is covered, full of, bounded with the full of water, only water. So next, this Tasmania Island, which I said, these islands are founded by the dark sailor, which is the name of the Tasman. The full name is Abdul Tasman. It is in your book. I think it, that is in your book in the get to know something like that. That is, from that you can read that the name, that person who founded the Tasmania Islands. Now next is the boundaries. Here is the north, south, east, west. This is drawing it about the Australia. So in the northern there is an ocean that is called Arafura Sea. Next is the in the southern part, there is the Southern Sea, means in the south. Next is in the east, that is South Pacific Ocean, Pacific Ocean, and here is the Indian Ocean. That is the north, south, east, west. In the north, it is the Arafura Sea. In the south, it is the Southern Sea. East, South Pacific Ocean. And the west, that is the Indian Ocean. And all islands which are together made the Oceania, all islands are from the Indian Ocean and the South Pacific Ocean. From these seas, these are the islands which have together, all together made the ocean. These are the neighboring countries of the Australia. In between them, all these are the water. These all the islands countries, these are the neighboring countries. First is the Indonesia. This is the Indonesia, the neighboring countries. Next is the Papua New Guinea. Next is the Solomon Island. This one is the Fiji. And this one is the New Zealand. So these are the neighboring countries. First is the Indonesia, next Papua New Guinea, next the Solomon Islands, next is the Fiji Island and the New Zealand. All together, all the islands of the Australia, together this is the Oceania. But Oceania plus Australia, it is together, it is called Australasia. Together, Oceania and the Australia, that is called Australasia. So this is the from the first I explained about the Australia. First is the name of the about the name of the Australia. Next is the location of Australia. Then boundaries. These things I explained. And one more thing, that is the Australia is the with the federation, it is a federation, and federation with the 6 states and 2 territories. These names you will get from your book, from the page number 90 from your book, there is a chart from that you will get, and the capital name also you will get from that. And up to that, today I will explain, and next day I will come with the major the physical features which are there are the 5 main physical features of Australia. These physical features with the these physical features I will come to the in the next class. Okay, I hope you will understand what the name come where the names come from, location, boundaries, all about the Australia. Read from your book properly, go through from your book. I will give you the question answers, but all the question answer will be the 1 marks or maximum 2 marks. More than not, that I will not give you. So read your book properly. Thank you.